Rick, the phone line's talked to Bob, listening in Washington. Hi, Bob.
Yeah, Hank, thank you for taking my call.
Pleasure.
So, mostly I want to thank you for just speaking the truth to all of us, well, across the country and apparently around the world. I have a question specifically in Luke 16. I'm leading a men's Bible study, and we're on Luke 16, specifically the verse 9.
Yeah, so you want the explanation of what's going on there. This is a parable.
Yes, it is a parable in regards to money, which, as some of us have seen it, it seems that the master is praising his servant for being deceptive. And I don't believe there's any contradictions in the Bible, first off, but there's just some confusion on what this means. So I just thought I'd get your overview of it.
Sure. The point of the parable is that the unrighteous are better at using money to make friends in the world than believers are at using money to make friends for the kingdom of God, which is accomplished by spending it on the needy, the poor, the downtrodden. And at death, the needy are going to welcome their benefactors into the everlasting home of God. And they will be then together for all eternity. So it's not a commendation to be dishonest. It is a parable that is being used to make a point. And one of the things I try to teach people about parables is you don't want to try to make the parable walk on all fours. What you want to understand is the point of the parable, and this is indeed its point.